It was very, very difficult. We forced them to fight. We gave them no choice. Elle and Bob and HBO and Showtime were going back and forth trying to make the fight happen. It was a battle, but everybody is happy now and it's time to give the people what they want to see. Everyone was saying, sign the contract. Sign the contract, as soon as Aram signed and as soon as Manny signed. Al Heyman brought the contract right to me and I signed the contract with no problem at all, stated. Undefeated pound for pound King Floyd Mayweather. Who talked about how his May 2nd showdown with 8th Division World Champion Manny Pacquiao was finally able to be made after 6 years in the making. According to Mayweather, it was his hour-long meeting with Pacquiao, following their encounter at a Miami Heat game, that allowed his powerful and influential advisor, Al Heyman, to finalize what had been a difficult back-and-forth process. I think how we were able to make the fight this time was me sitting down and meeting with Pacquiao, one-on-one. Once we sat down one-on-one, it had an awful lot to do with Al Heyman. I stayed on top of Al day in and day out. Stephen A. Spinoza and Ellen Leonard Ellerb was communicating back and forth all day just trying to make the fight happen. It was extremely difficult, but like I said before, I'm truly blessed to be in a position to make 9 figures in 36 minutes, Mayweather explained during a recent conversation with FightType.com. Al Heyman, I couldn't choose a better man to have in my corner. He's been like a father to me. He has taught me about business. He's such a brilliant businessman. He came to my house. We was at my house sitting down in Vegas. We had a meeting just about business outside of boxing. But then we got to talking about boxing. I said, what do you think about the Pacquiao fight? He said, I really don't know. Do you want the fight? I said, absolutely. I said, can you make it happen? He said, I can try my best. And I said, well, you told me we don't ever try to do anything. We do it. So can you do it? He said, I'ma do it, and that's what we did, Mayweather added. The great thing about my career is I did it my way. A lot of guys are forced to do things that they don't want to do. I honestly believe that. At this particular time, even if Pacquiao didn't want to fight, he has no choice because his back is against the wall. The reason why his back is against the wall is because he needs the money, I don't. Every property that I have from Miami to LA to Las Vegas is paid for, so I'm blessed. And I didn't do it by myself. My team is around me every day and everybody that has supported me throughout my 19-year career.
Well, you heard it there. Floyd Mayweather saying how he forced the negotiations and he really wanted him and Al. They sat down with Leon Edderby and Espinosa. And they hatched it out and they've gave the fight fans what we want. So we've got the fight now, what we finally wanted. So it's Floyd's in his own words, regardless of anything happens, it's going to happen on May 5th, Cinco de Mayo. And we're going to get it on, man. Like, should be a good fight. Whoever wins, hopefully boxing wins, the boxer wins out. And man, this is going to be a good year of boxing. So anyway, you leave your comments. I'm EJ Boxing Live and I'll catch you another one.
DJ Boxing Live here.
Buster Douglas, knock him out. Buster Douglas, the fat compliment of legends. I mean,
yo, this is Chris Caban, chilling with my man DJ Boxing Live, one of the hottest, dopest boxing channels on YouTube. Check him out.
He was the number 10 rating contender, and he had never been knocked down. And Sonny destroyed his mouth. Sophia lost most of his teeth, basically with one or two left hooks.
Oh, shit, boy. What was look at kids sleeping like Manny Pacquiao?
EJ Boxing Live here. EJ Boxing Live here.